Now we almost look evenly sized.
What are we going to talk about today?
Carrying stuff. Farmers' carries and loaded carries and carries and carries and putting stuff on you and putting stuff around you and picking stuff up and carrying stuff.
Totes, totes!
No.
Totes, totes! Totes.
That's comic genius. This might be a giveaway. So you probably know I compete in strongman competitions and have done so for a while. And so strongman consists of basically four things. You pick something up off the ground, you put something over your head, you throw something, that's hit or miss in competitions, but you'll see that more and more, and you carry something. And it's some variation of all those things. And so carrying stuff obviously is something I do in competition. But here's the beauty of it. I found that from all that carrying of things, I make it sound like it's my discovery, I found there is so much benefit to it, to anyone. And it's such a simple thing to do. Therefore, we're gonna call it very, very
underrated.
For such a simple task, you pick something up off the ground and you take it somewhere else. And there are so many ways of doing that. And any level of trainee, any level of person with a moving practice can do some version of it. And I'm gonna say we should do some version of it. We should be picking stuff up. We should be carrying it on our shoulders, in front of us, over our head, at our sides. We should even be dragging and pushing things, moving things from one place to another. Can actually add a whole lot of presence and awareness and understanding to our bodies.
What muscles do those work?
All of them. Never asked that question. He knows better.
I think I blew my wad with totes, totes.
That's it. Intellectual capacity overloaded. The last video we made was two videos combined because they were both pretty short because we were both in very much agreement that they were things we support. This is sort of the same way. There's not much to talk about except to say that until you try it, until you actually try seriously overloading your body and carrying something, you won't know what it's like.
Yeah, we're not talking about just carrying in your groceries. And we're not even talking about that lazy trip where you try to get all the bags in one trip, right? We're talking some heavy carries. And, you know, there's a place for lighter offloaded carries like single arm kettlebell carries and things like that. But odds are you don't have, or your gym doesn't have a kettlebell heavy enough for what we're talking about. We're talking about approaching your max deadlift and trying to carry that. Mm-hmm.
In fact, we know from competition that you can carry more than your max deadlift. So if you can pick it up, you should be able to probably carry it. So for today, we're gonna take a yoke for a walk, which is one of my favorites because it's one of the hardest for me. I am not a natural body to go around taking a heavy thing on my back places. And yet, I love doing it in competition because it is such a huge challenge. Even if I don't go super heavy, which means even if I only do 1.5 times body weight or double body weight, for yoke in competition, that's not very heavy for a lightweight. Is there a fly that's just going to the same spot?
Yeah, you got a Mike Pence fly flying around your head.
You know, in competition, for a lightweight competitor, we often have to do more than 3 times our body weight. So let's say I'm only doing 2 times body weight on the yoke, or even less than that. The yoke is still quite a bit of a challenge. It really gets me to walk away from the yoke feeling like I did a lot, like my entire body participated in that movement. I understand my spine, I understand how to pack everything down, how to stack everything, and I have this enhanced awareness of myself just from that simple, simple act of putting something on my back really heavy and walking with it. And you can have a similar experience by holding really heavy things or by putting something like a sandbag on you. It doesn't really matter what you use, but I do recommend using something relatively heavy, with the exception of going overhead. If you try something overhead, you don't have to go near as heavy, but keeping arms as straight as possible and in line with your spine as much as possible and walking with it, that's a challenge. Lock those arms. Make sure you have that great overhead position where your arms are straight over your heels. They're not out in front of you, because then that weight will drop. So you have to have the mobility to be able to do this. And away you go. one arm, two arms, barbell, dumbbells, kettlebells, sandbags, person, whatever you got. You can try the overhead version of it as well. You can carry multiple things. You can carry one thing. You can carry it overhead. You can carry it at your side. You can carry it on your shoulder. You can carry one thing on your shoulder and at your side, or one thing on your shoulder and overhead, or one thing overhead and at your side. You have so many options.
The possibilities are endless.
And so for today, I'm just going to take a yoke for a walk, and then I'm going to take a pair of farmer's walk handles for a walk. Farmer's walk handles are simply handles with weight on them that you hold at your side. You can do that with kettlebells or dumbbells or even barbells, although the balance is a bit of a challenge. You can also throw really heavy sandbags on yourself, or you can honestly use other people. There's so many versions of carrying stuff. So one of the combos we like to do, sometimes in my workouts, you'll see it programmed a lot in the stuff I program, especially on the upcoming new Body Tribe website that'll be here soon-ish. You'll see how I like to program where we do something at one end of a distance. Could be anything. Could be kettlebell swings, could be push-ups, could be whatever. And then you carry something to another end, do something there, and carry something back. Putting carries within a workout, within a combo, within a training situation is really easy. Or just do them by themselves. They're fantastic. Cover some distance if you have it. Get outside, throw something on your shoulder, throw something over your head, go for a walk with it.
You'll notice Dave and I have different yoke styles. It's because we're built differently. When you're a smaller guy like me, putting the hands way out on the edge, like the bigger guys do, doesn't make a lot of sense, especially if I'm really trying to turn on my lats. So I bring my hands in and get a much tighter lat position, almost like you're at the beginning of a bent press or you're at the top of a pull-up. It helps me a lot more lock in. But I don't have enough chunk in the back to be able to put my hands down, nor am I wide enough to be able to put my hands down and make a decent shelf. Now, some people do that and they bring their elbows up to make more of a trap, where they can put the bar on the thickness of their traps. But if you get a smaller guy like me doing that, it doesn't work. So I have to pull in and turn my lats on to lock that bar in place. This guy here, he's got more chunk in the back. He can put his arms out and he can actively push forward, maybe even up a little, but it doesn't work for me.
I'm chunky.
And I do have an entire video for yoke for skinny people right here.
No, they I think they listen to you more. I'm the one. They're like, oh shit, he's talking again. Blah, blah, blah. Oh, Dave spoke. And you can...
This thing is...
You took off too.
Oh no, he's back!
Motherfucker. We'll do something at one end of a situation. That's a ladybug. A ladybug just landed on me. Come here.
Aww.
Come here. But you know what? You can stay here, but I'm going to put you on my finger. Okay. I have a new friend.
Alabama bugs be like, what's this?
What's this? California blood.
It's imported.
It's imported. Fine blood wine. Oh, jeez. How are your vampires around here? I saw a whole series about them. And what was it? True Blood? They were all Alabaman.
Yeah.
We don't talk about that, apparently.
We don't all sound like that.
The sex scenes on that show were so horrible to watch because they're all so sweaty all the time.
Well, just, it is hot down there.
I know. That just said a lot about me, isn't it? I like my sex dry and unsweaty.